as far as the series is concerned. With that said, obviously we're moving along with the picks here. Again, lines up 1-0. I did get enough. I actually joined a little bit late because of how quickly it started, and I was still setting up. But support was kind enough to let me know how the initial bans went after I joined. Zlapped was the one that banned Ophelia, and then Hanskin banned Scout, and then it was Slither and to Engineer. So Denial banned Ophelia, Slither, and Lines banned Scout Engineer. So there you go, a little bit of extra insight there. So as far as the bans coming out, so a little bit of reaction obviously from last game, especially with that Slither. Denali Esports definitely respecting it this time around. But again, that's the tough thing about a team like Lions. I mean, they're so diverse with just the amount of heroes that pretty much all their players can play. And, you know, the initial bans, obviously, you ban a couple of certain amount of heroes. You know, the Slither in this case, they're like, okay, well, we'll just go another carrier out. In fact, you already see the Corrupted Disciple being right-clicked by Lion Esports Club. So they're not one-dimensional by any means, which makes them very difficult to play against, which is really the most case against really all the top-tier teams. So anyways, picks moving along here. The Ravener first pick coming out from Denial, so valuing that big time. Want to keep it out of the hands of Super KGE and also just pick it up for themselves. But first pick, Ravener, followed by the Tempest. That gets Denial to respond with the Keeper. Don't want to give up that combo. But then Devourer coming out from Lion Esports Club. So how about that? They go the Devourer route here. They say, you want to have a Ravener? We're just fine with that. We'll go Devourer. And we'll put it in the hands of Super KGE. So obviously a fan-favorite hero-player combination coming out right there with the Devourer being played by Super KGE. Excited to see how that turns out. Empath being picked up by Denial. And again, I feel like I say this every single time, but it's no surprise seeing it picked up by Denial Esports, specifically because of support. Just knows what he's doing with that hero, and more than likely going to end up running that Ravener-Empath combination. Wretched Hag, of course, very Lion-like right there. They finish off with the Hag, so the thing with Lion Esports Club, though, they can very easily run a Suicide Hag or the Short Lane Hag, so still no obviousness there. There are some other teams out there very rarely to never run it as a Suicide option nowadays, but Lion still is one of those teams that more than willing to run a Suicide Wretched Hag when it comes down to it. Jonas Fan plays it well, just like Fousey, so not a whole lot of extra information given out there necessarily. So we'll see how the draft continues on, specifically for Lion Esports Club. There's the Warbeast ban. Again, I was talking about that last game. Warbeast was left open the whole game by both sides. Not addressed in the bans or the picks eventually. Made it all the way through. That is, I mean, it's always funny seeing certain heroes like that here, where in some matchups, he will be first banned. I mean, TMSR is a perfect example. Stay Green, for the matter. Those are teams that if Warbeast is on the board, they will snatch that hero up most likely. In this case, both of these teams, I mean, Lions definitely, they're not known for playing it as much as those two teams, and I guess neither is Denial Esports when you really think about it, so it's just a case of that. Like, the last game, he just simply made it through, and even Lions with their final pick, they went with the Midas in the end, but they could have easily gotten the more routine Warbeast pickup as that Suicide option. But obviously, I was very happy, and I'm sure a lot of people were, that they went the Midas in the end, especially since they made it work out too. And again, he wasn't necessarily the biggest impact, let's be frank, but it was only a 15-minute game, so you know, there's only so much you could see from that game with it. But it was still fun to see, nonetheless. Bubbles coming out right here as the follow-up pick now from Denial. You also look at the other bans real quickly. It was Glacius, Sanrai, Torturer, Warby, Succubus, Moon Queen. They banned Succubus once again. Succubus has been popping up here and there. Lions is doing it. IG has been doing it. The Suicide Succubus is both the Suicide or the Support Option Succubus have been ones that have been coming out. So Denial is going to prevent that from happening here. Nymphora is the response from Lions. They're going to go the Nymphora route here. They don't really often go the Nymphora route. And Nymphora, again, is that support hero. She has died off a lot, especially since Pebbles isn't seen as frequently anymore. Has died off quite a bit. But every now and then she will be picked up, such as here. And so we'll see how she shapes up with Devourer. Of course, having that Grace of the Nymph really lets Devourer to willingly spam that hook even more. And Super KG is going to love that. Hooky being right-click. That would be something. Quick update, by the way. Obviously, the other series, I know a lot of people intrigued by that, as am I. Stay Green versus TMSR. I believe they are in game number two right now, so as you can see, a fairly even start to game number two. But I believe game one was handled pretty easily by Stay Green in the end. I did check in at the last second before it finished right there, and it seems like Stay Green had a pretty hefty lead. I don't know if it would actually be in here just yet. No, that's on the recent gaming match, so wouldn't be in there just yet. But anyways, I believe they had a pretty hefty lead going to the finish there, and hence the game one victory for them. So they're up 1-0 in that series, but again, we'll see how they finish off against too much sugar over there. All right, so with that said, you look back at Lion Esports Club now and where they're going to finish off with. You got a couple of odd, not even, I guess more so interesting is a better way to put it. Heroes being right-clicked from Emerald Warden now. And again, we just saw, what was it that we just saw before that? I'm blanking now. Another different hero, too, that we don't usually see. But where will they go? Where will Lion Esports go with that final pick? Again, they could run the Suicide Hack, or they could do the Shoreline Hack and pick up Suicide option here instead. They're going to think about it, though. They got about 30 seconds remaining, so they need to finish it off. Dr. Repulsor, by the way, was the final pick. Oh, yes. Okay, was the other one. Emerald Warden coming out. How about that? So, again, Lion Esports Club going a little bit different here. Going a little bit different. They go the short lane Emerald Warden, more than likely. So, it is going to end up in Wretched Hag being played by Jonas Afan here for that suicide role. Fousey on the Warden. This is going to be fun. You know, we have seen, we did see Warden pop up a while back. It was in that support role, though. I forget exactly the match. I want to say Stay Green did it for some reason, but it's been a while, man. It's been a while. You talk about another hero that definitely has had his time on the competitive scene. He had it for a little bit, again, back at some Dream Hacks ago. And what was a decent carry option, he's a great laner, obviously, with that Wolf Spam. His silencing shot is a very powerful tool. I mean, the top, how it's plus the 100 plus your attack damage as magic damage on top of a 5-second silence at level 4. I mean, that's a long, long silence, man, for a single target. And with some good damage on top of that, it's very spammable, too, only a 10-second cooldown. And then the traps, obviously, can be annoying. Traps also great for blocking camps on top of that and being annoying in that way. And then the ultimate, obviously, that passive ultimate, but extra, you know, extra kill potential, extra push potential and whatnot, so... and helping to keep him alive even. So, yeah, just an all-around, you know, just a solid hero, a very simple hero, you could say, when it comes down to it. Obviously, he is known as one of more the simplified heroes, you know, with, again, the passive ultimate, the being able to press W and have the wolves do pretty much go to the target no matter where they are as long as they're in the range. It's also a great scouting tool. So, yeah, obviously nothing against Alliance for picking it up here. But, again, it is one of the more simpler heroes, you could say. But going to be played in that carry kind of format here for Lion Esports Club. But, you know, I kind of like it too because, again, she is a hero that, yeah, she can scale a little bit into the later game stage when you factor in the silencing shot with the plus your attack as magic damage. I mean, she could put out some good damage eventually. She is that agility range carry to an extent, you know, not as legit as other ones for sure. But this is more of a mid-game style carry, though. I mean, she's not one that's going to compete later game against the top carries by any means. And even something like a Dr. Paul, I would think you'd even give it to... Well, at the same time, though, I mean, that's actually looking at that matchup now a little bit more. The Emerald Warden, yeah, the silencing shot, man. What better way to lock down a doctor than with the silence? And having a 10-second cooldown, 5-second silencing shot on a hero like Dr. Repulsor will be huge here in this game. So, you know, I was just about to sit here and say how Doctor, you know, arguably with even Farm or whatnot, could be the more powerful late game scaling hero. with this matchup specifically, that silencing shot is, again, pretty damn effective against him. And then they got the Tempest Hole, of course, to help lock him down. The Devo Nom Nom Nom, as I call it, or what's called the Devour on him. So they do have ways to keep Dr. Repulsor in place here on the Hellpoint side. And that's obviously a good thing to have when you're going up against this hero. So... Obviously, a pause to kick off here. Oh, that'll give me time to switch the interface over once again. I apologize for that. There we go. All right, so here we are again, once again. Lion Esports Club up 1-0 over Denali Esports. Obviously, guys, so we got this weekend here. We got this series here today. Then, of course, we're going to be coming back tomorrow. We got the Loser Bracket Finals, which will be followed up by the Grand Finals. And then we're going to be off until, technically we're going to be off. Okay, so here's the deal. Obviously, the DreamHack coverage is not going to be on the Honkast stream. It's going to be on the DreamHack stream. It's being the production, the tournament itself, and everything. It's being run 100% by the DreamHack side. So myself and Beef, we're going to be the casters, but it's on DreamHack for the production and their stream and everything. So there will be more information on that as well on the Honkast website and everything. But and also on the Honkast's Twitch page. We'll have information letting you guys know. I believe, I'm not exactly sure on the exact stream name. It's twitch.tv/DreamHack, and it's going to be like DreamHack TV 2 or something like that. I'm not, again, we'll have to wait and see what exactly it is once the event comes around, but we'll have many links to it and make sure you find it. It will also be embedded on the Honcast site, I believe, as well. So, you know, worst comes to worst, you can just find it there when it comes down to it. But again, just to clarify that, it's not actually going to be on the Honcast stream. It will be on a DreamHack stream for the DreamHack tournament, which starts next Thursday. So after this weekend, again, I'm going to be getting on a plane on Monday and flying out. And I actually get in Sweden personally on Tuesday with a bunch of the other S2 crew. And we're going to be starting to hang out, have some fun, get settled in, meet the players and everything, say hey, say hi to the fans. And for all those for all of you that are going to be going, especially the CB Kappas, looking forward to saying hi to all of you as always. I always have a lot of fun at events like this, especially DreamHacks, man. This will personally be my sixth. Is it six? It's my sixth DreamHack. I believe. Is it my seventh? You know what? Actually, I think it might be my. I have to think. I want to say it's my sixth. Six, maybe seventh. Anyways, point being, I've been there quite a bit, and I've been. It's always a humbling experience. You know, being able to see you guys, being able to see people that you know love Han, just you know, you have obviously similarities to talk about. You know, you're passionate about the same thing, and just being able to hang out in general. So going to an event like DreamHack, it's always so much fun. And I really just cannot wait to get back there. Also saying hi to all the players once again. It's always just a great, great atmosphere. And you know, especially, I mean, I know it's like that for like kind of all the different games and everything. But the Haunting especially, man, I've been around the gaming scene in general for a while now, the esports and whatnot. And I'll say going to the events, the Haunting seems to stand out a little bit more as far as just having some fun characters. You know, we were just not afraid to have a good time at events like this. And but I know, the gaming scene, the esports scene in general, though, it could definitely just be a fun experience. No matter what the game is, frankly, but love being a part of the Haunting. Anyways, enough about that. I'm getting emotional here. I'm going to start tearing up. Here we are in game number two. Again, so you see some rotations right off the bat actually coming out. So you see what DNL's doing here. Empath, Raven are going to be at the top side. So they send the aggressive dual lane coming out here from DNL. They're doing a 2-1-2 setup in the end. Interesting. More so, I guess, 2-1-1-2. Of course, they have Keeper of the Forest in the jungle, actually. So, yeah, choosing to run the jungle Keeper, being played by Slaptier. They go the aggressive dual lane, but now with this rotation, now you're matching up against a Nymphora Emerald Warden. It is Raven or Empath. I mean, it's kind of an awkward stun follow-up there from Empath. It's not guaranteed by many means by Raven either with the Paul Lightning. So, I don't know if I expect DNL to have the best time up here. I mean, if they do get a ball lining off, obviously, which is possible, then being able to respond off of that could very likely set up a kill. But because at the same time, you do look at Nymphora and Ember Warden, and they're not necessarily the best in terms of stomping once it's going in terms of getting jumped. But having that double range, I mean, Ember Warden's range as well, 625. You have Nymphora that's looking at 550. Compared to Empath, who's at 600, and then, of course, Ravener being the melee. Definitely an advantage there for the Hellborn team. Middle lane, Bubbles actually shell surfing away. And I wonder if it had to do a little bit with this as well. They didn't want to match up against Devourers, or Super KG's Devourer. I was about to say he's Devourer Super KG. Might as well say that, right? So, you know, maybe they decided to have the Bubbles against him instead. Obviously, Bubbles is a little more favorable in the D.Va matchup with that takeover and whatnot. In fact, he already has it, of course. And being able to dodge those hooks a little bit easier. Dr. Repulsor, some good damage on a Wretched Ag down here. Hag's forced to fall back and activate the health potion before getting too low, of course, but obviously it's going to be fine in the end. Back to farming she goes, but good force of regen coming out there. And speaking of that, though, Dr. Repulsor currently out of regen. I think Wretched Ag knows it. She's playing a little extra aggressive right here, putting in the auto attacks, but Doctor kind of holding his ground. He lays down the Electric Turd and puts in the counter himself, so. But without having regen currently, needs to be a little careful. He's probably waiting up for the 600 to get the bottle here, but we'll see where he goes. He's going to the side shot now. May just get the boots, actually. Okay, he's going to get the boots here. So he's still going to be lacking the regen. And again, Jonas Fan's a smart player. I'm sure he's going to be picking up on that. He's not even going he doesn't have Sonar Scream yet, of course. He is going the Haunt build here on top of that. As you see the top lane, the Wolves are going to start coming out from Emerald Warden. Those are level 2 Wolves now, the Hunter's Command. And even more effective. And that's another thing about Emerald Warden, especially if she's in a matchup against two heroes. Obviously, being able to get some guaranteed damage on both of the heroes, nearly guaranteed damage. I mean, you just look at the range right there. Ravenor is so far back, and it still chases him down and gets the hit off. So, I mean, granted, you know, it could be some fairly decent mana cost, 100 mana cost for each use. But she has the Ring of the Teacher. She does have a mana battery with those charges. Not yet, but can add up those charges, so ideally can use that pretty frequently. And then, oh yeah, has a level 2 Grace of the Nymph nearby. So, yeah, this the being able to spam the Wolves here is just another thing that DNL is going to have to really, really get frustrated with even. And I wouldn't be surprised by that if it just becomes a difficult time for them. But Hanskins, he's level 5. He's near there. He's not going to look for a gank, though. He's just going to continue his merry way, continue to farm. He actually just got his Pickled Brain right there, so Ring of Sorcery going to be coming out for him. Dr. Repulsor, in the meantime, against Wretched Hag. How is that shaping up? Is there action top? Ravener taking a little bit of damage right there. Looks like the Sonic Shot was used, but he's going to be fine. He does have 10 mana battery charges. He's going to go balls to the wall right here. On there, 4-4, taking some good damage. The Seal Slayer comes out, but not nearly enough. Good damage coming out for the Legion side. Ravener still going in. They want to get Wretched Hag, Emerald Warden as well, but not enough. But they do get her to fall back and use the Regen herself. So Bloodlust kill does come out for the Ravener and 4 combination. Oh, super KGE trying to make the big hook right there, but Mickey able to take cover in time. So very good, well played with both players, frankly. I mean, Devour did a good job in, predicting the port, of course. But at the same time, Mickey responding just in time with the take cover to avoid the hook right there. So a little bit of back and forth. But yeah, Bloodlust kill for Denial Esports, especially at this top lane. A lane that's been, I'm sure, very annoying for them and to deal with. But they able to make the best of it there. So that is a good start for them. But okay, back to this bottom line. I wanted to look at that. Dr. Pulsar. He is currently 14-5. Wretched Hag is 23-13. So Wretched Hag is off to a definitely the better start here. Jonas the fans really taking advantage, and I think again the lack of regen earlier on in Flensmeyer has just really been hurting him. And Jonas fan being a smart player that he is, he's really taking advantage of that. So Tempest has a Ring of Sorcery. He's level 7 already. Has an ultimate ready to go. He's actually the top farm in the game by quite a bit. Even 345 gold per minute. So Hanskin, I mean, he's showing what he can make happen with the free farm in the jungle. Granted, his pull camp was blocked, but obviously that's not the biggest deal in the world. Nowadays, I mean, junglers are used to one, if not two, camps being blocked the whole time, it feels like, earlier on. So, Hanskin still making the by far the best of it and continues to actually go at it. He went top, but he obviously was spotted coming in there. So, Ravener and Empath fall back, play very defensive. But Fousey, his farm also is solid. So, yeah, Ravener, despite that kill coming out, Empath even got the kill. The GPM is struggling here. Probusca's minimal creep kills. Only 11-1 compared to the 29-6 Emerald Warden. So focused on that Bloodlust kill that they got. That was actually really good news. But at the same time, they are still struggling. I mean, again, the lack of creep farm is showing here on their side. Dr. Repulsor. He is, where is he? He's right here. He's once again taking some extra pressure. Right, checking with a double damage rune, actually. Oh, he needs to be careful. Those laps coming in. He doesn't have his root just yet. Okay, now he has mana. He just got the mana for it. Dr. Pulsar going in. Here comes Keep of the Forest. Jonas Fan knows something's up. He has a blink. He's not even going to use it, though. Meanwhile, Super KG gets Kona Bubbles in the middle lane. And now at the top lane, Empath being pressured. Ravener stuns Tempest. He's not going to port in, though. Can support survive the Essence Link coming out, but not enough. And down falls Empath. So obviously, the end result right there, Lightning Sports Club definitely coming up top. All three lanes. They get the kill middle and top, and Wretched Hag lives after the gank attempt being set up right there. Well played once again by Lightning Sports Club, and that lead is starting to continue here earlier on in this game. Ring of Sorcery is picked up by Slap now, so definitely has more mana to work with here. Still going to look for a very possible opportunity. In fact, Bubbles coming in as well, so they really want to make something happen. But now Jonas the Fan realizes something's up. I mean, Bubbles is not mid just yet. If anything, there's some good team communication coming out here from Lion Esports Club. So they're playing passive enough to prevent Denial Esports from getting any free kills. So Lions once again projecting off a very good start here. 8 minutes coming in, already a 3,000 gold lead, about a 3,300 experience lead. The Wolves continuing to be spammed. Level 3 Wolves here as Ghost marches early on, has his boots of choice here. I was like, what the hell is this, by the way? I thought it was like a Petted in Fours for the second. That's a Fairy Courier, I guess? Interesting. Empath, okay. That is doing some damage. No, just a little bit of creep damage, but Wretched Hag, though, Jonas Fan. GPM not the most impressive, but again, creep farm-wise, he is out farming the Dr. Repulsor, and is at 267 gold per minute, so being a suicide hag, once again, not too shabby at all. Mickey on bubbles, his start also hasn't been the most fantastic. He is actually competing in Creep Farm with Devour, but that death most certainly hurting him as usually would. Nymphora is also getting close to that level 6 mark, so we'll see who or when, if she starts to get very active with that or not. Wretched Agantivo collapsed on the bottom lane, though, to take out Dr. Pulse right there. And now Keeper of the Force might be in a little bit of trouble. He's going to send the trees on him, though, so they get very typical for any hook attempts. Top tower, invulnerability coming out. Lions wants to get this, but the deny attempt from Denial, will it be successful? No, it won't. Kelfo comes out, though. The wall on top of that hand's getting in some trouble. He takes the stuff from Ravener. He has an ultimate to use right here. Is he going to look to use it? Rue coming out? No, he's not. He falls. In the process, Hammer Warden and Nymphora running away. And it looks like that's how it'll end for now. Hellborn team, though, they're fighting back. Elmo Warden wants to make something happen. Silencing shot's not going to be enough. The Wolves, will it be enough? No! Just enough life there on Keeper of the Forest. And he barely lifts the hook just out of range as well. So Lions wanted to get some revenge for Tempest, but not able to get there in time. Again, they did get the tower kill, though. And Tempest still has his Elemental Void. He didn't panic use it right there. So, yeah, not the end of the world by any means for Lions. In fact, you can still argue that they came out on top there of that fight. But, oh, Ravener, he did not realize Devourer was still nearby. That's a real Devourer. Nice job with the ball lining. Will it be enough? No. Well, there's the hook. And there's the ultimate coming out for Devourer. Easy kill set up onto Ravener. That was a big misplay by Probusk right there. I mean, he even reacted very late from Devourer, too, as soon as he saw him. I don't know if he's just trying to dodge a hook or not, but that was just unfortunate position. And now Bubbles needs to be careful. Kind of the same situation. You do see a Ward of Sidus here as well coming out from Lions. So some good vision around this area. They know what's up. Nymphora is level 6 now. As soon as they see Dr. Bottom here, I would not be surprised if they've seen the TV. But there's the hook on the Bubbles. He uses the song and see the shots are coming out. But Emerald Warden expected the placement of the port. And he gets bursted down after that. Wretched Ag also coming to the flank. The teamwork right here by Lions is just really on the ball, man. I mean, going from the first game now to the second game, we really are seeing some just great teamwork coming out. I mean, I talked about that in the Stay Green versus Reason Gaming series earlier on in this week that we casted. Stay Green just looked phenomenal in that series. Again, these teams getting ready for DreamHack, and it is showing. It really is. Dr. Pulse, as I said, though, they poured in. Dr. Pulse, he just runs right up to him! Doctor was not expecting that! He runs right up to him! He holds him down with the ultimate, and down goes Dr. Repulsor. It's feeling like Devourer's invisible part of this game, because that's the second time where the top lane, it was with Ravener. He didn't seem to notice him initially. And the bottom lane, Dr. Repulsor takes a little bit to react. And before you know it, he's getting devoured and eventually falls. So, man, I mean, this game here, it's Lions again. They like I said, though, they're most certainly one of the favorites going into the DreamHack Winter 2013 event. And they are using this tournament, if anything, not only to try to get better positioning in cycle or in the Haunt Tour Season 2, but through 7 cycles, but also, you know, as momentum. And I really am a firm believer in that, as far as going into a big event like DreamHack, that using that momentum coming off in big tournaments, it could definitely be all about that. Now, granted, I keep going back to as well, I mean, this is, I really also feel like this is going to be the most even DreamHack we've ever had when it comes down to it. We have just all very, very quality teams, and yes, there are the favorites. Obviously, Stay Green and Lions definitely at top of that chart. But again, it really, if the teams play at the top of any of these top tier teams, all the teams that qualified, they can defeat one another, no doubt. I mean, on any given Sunday, if teams having a bad day at DreamHack, other teams having a great day, any team can be any team. And that's been proven by stats throughout Haunt Tour, as of late especially. So, and with all the teams that have qualified so far, it really can happen. So that is exciting stuff, knowing that that's the case going into the DreamHack Winter event. So I know I keep talking about DreamHack Winter. This is Haunt Tour. But again, it's a big event. It's coming up, man. It's next week. So I just want to continue to hype it up as much as possible, of course. So back to this game, though. We are approaching the 13-minute mark. 6,200 gold lead as well as a 6,500 experience lead here in favor of Lion Esports Club, of course. And you see Nymphora. He does have the teleport ready to go. Devourer trying to be sneaky. He's using the illusion right here. He knows that they want to maybe jump him. He's baiting it out. Look at that. He's even getting last hits. That he's not showing that he's weak on damage. How about that? Nymphora, though. Nymphora's TPing bottom. Dr. Pulsar knew something was up, though. She's able to, or he in this case, able to react before he gets caught. Going to be fine. Dr. Pulsar laying down the electric turret. Devourer, will he try for a hook attempt here? Melbourne team, Lions is chasing. Oh, they're going to collapse. Retrodack jumps in. Empath goes inside of Bubbles. Gutfoot coming out. Darker Fultz turning the party. But Bubbles gets sucked by Devour in the background. He's going to shell surf in, though. Down goes Retrodack. Down goes Nymphora. Beautiful read on top of that. Zlapt ends up getting the double tapped, actually. And now Ravenous chasing Tempest. Tempest in some trouble. He has an elemental void. Can he find the opportunity? Devour nearby as well. Hanskin kind of going back in. He's stutter-stepping a little bit. Devour now realizing might not want to go and fold it. Emerald Warden joining the party, though. The wolves are coming. The wolves are hunting. He puts the seismic shot on to keep it the forest. Keep it the forest. Doesn't have a root. It doesn't matter. The nice lock on him. Good job with the impasse done, though. But it might not matter in the end. Dust is out, and yes, Keep It The Forest will eventually fall. Ratchetak buys back, by the way. Jonas the Fan back into the fight. She's going to look to finish off Empath. She will finish off Empath. And now Alliance Esports Club going to go back to this first tower. So they did use some buyback on Hag, but, I mean, did now look like they were actually looking. They were pretty damn good at the beginning of that fight. They got a double tap on a keeper to start on the Hag Nymphora, but obviously the end result was that of Lions coming back, getting the tower, and also cleaning up with the hero kill. So you do see some items coming along here, so let's take a quick glance at that before more action picks up. Wretched Dagger, of course, the Light Brand going to be in the works here. Emerald Warden going the Assassin Shroud, actually. So playing the very aggressive here. Again, this is style that you could definitely play, very aggressive ganking kind of role. Going to be going the Assassin Shroud. And her burst damage is pretty damn good with her Silencing Shot. With the ultimate, the Gawain, if that makes sense. Gawain? That wouldn't make sense. Oh, support gets picked off there, and Devour still wants food. He's hungry, damn it. He's damn hungry. He's a big boy. Bubbles in trouble now. He's going to need to take over. Shells away. The Sizing Shot comes out, though. That'll prevent the port. Down he goes. Dr. Pulsar wants revenge. Damn it. Will he get it, though? The hook in right there. Dr. Pulsar, ludicrous speed away. He's going to be fine for now. Oh, the last auto attack's destroyed, and he is going to survive the wolves, though. 10-second cooldown. He is going to live when it's all said and done. So Dr. Pulsar does jet on out of there, but Lion Esports Club just continuing to be too aggressive for Denial East, or for Denial, yeah. And here you go, Ember Warden moving around with that Assassin Shroud. Looking for an opportunity right here. Gonna lay down a trap, actually. Both for vision and also see if they, in case they continue to chase after, but not gonna happen just yet. Doctor will run right into it, but only a level 1 trap, so minimal stun time. Those will be up to 4 seconds, though. Oh, and he's going to find some food right here. No, he ran right past the Rev Ward, actually. He was right on top of it. Doctor, he's going to take a silent shot. He is. Devour pointing right on top, basically. Bad Blast coming out. Devour trying to get the angle, but he's not going to be able to. It doesn't matter, though. The dot damage should be enough. Yep, dot damage is enough right there. Devour now cutting up here because they got more food. Bubbles and Empath. Bubbles has a takeover. Nice Empath wall. Wretched Hag says, I don't care about your walls, though. Flinks right on over. Here comes Ravener counter. Wretched Hag is dropping. Sun Screen coming out. Nice heal. Sun on top of that. The root comes out, though. And Wretched Hag will fall. Devour go for the hook. Oh, blind hook. Not going to connect. Wretched Hag, or excuse me, Emerald Warden, though. Still going to chase. Trying to catch Bubble. Sun Shot comes out a little too late, though. And now Lions might want to think about retreating here, which they are. I just figured this tower was already dead because of how continuing aggressive they continue to play, but they finally get that middle first tower. I mean, they were down here in this area for quite a bit here, and I just figured that tower was already destroyed, but they do finally get it. And again, looking back at item progression, you do see the Light Brand was finished on Hag now. You got Devour, that Shaman's Headdress, another 1,100 gold saved up. Keeper of the Forest also picking up a Shaman's Headdress, by the way, so he's going to be investing into a very early barrier idol here. So just completely passing up the idea of an Astrolabe or even like a portal key or anything like that. Wants the very defensive, and you know, I can see what I like that. I mean, it makes sense. This is continuing to be picking up more even as a very active game, and it is a lot of magic damage here on the Hellborn side. A lot of magic damage. I mean, even Emerald Warden is obviously with his silencing shot and the wolves on top, and that is magic, right? Yeah, that is magic, so a lot of magic damage coming out for the Hellborn team. So Barrier Idol, definitely a good investment here to come out for our Legion team. But the lead still is pretty damn strong for Lions. 12,000 gold lead, 9,000 experience lead. Kind of wonder if it's going to be too much for Denali Esports to overcome. Dr. Pulse, especially with his start, 185 goal per minute. I haven't even been paying too much attention to the goal per minute, but now that we glance at it, yeah, that's just a story right there, if anything. I mean, they are just not getting anything going. Keeper of the Force is the only one that's having something going. But obviously, Denali, they're in a spot. They're already down 1-0. This is why not play it out here, see if you can make anything happen, slowly grind your way back into the game. It is possible. Well, only if you have Moon Queen, apparently. Jokes. Jokes. Hook attempt from Devour. If they come to the left here. Oh, Ravener. Oh, Ravener! He's going to get caught. Yep, there's the catch. And an easy kill. That just happened so quickly, man. Especially in cases like that where you don't even see the hero in the first place. You're just grinding away at the creep wave, and all of a sudden, a hook out of nowhere just pulls you in, and with a double damage activated and the Bat Blast to the face. Yeah. Nothing Ravener could have done right there. So, easy kill on him. Toplin, what's going on up here? Kelpur coming out, actually, but Devour gets ported behind him for and Mickey ends up falling. So, he tries to stop them right there and help his team, but he ends up getting picked off. Now, this is going to be a top tower push in the process. You see Dr. Pulse trying to run away, if anything. Richard Hack coming in to cut him off. But Doctor just going to jet away with his ludicrous speed.
The Hellborn have destroyed a Legion Tower.
An easy tower kill. So Lion Esports Club just continuing to push as a team. 20-minute mark coming up. They're now going to be rotating middle here. And looking to push this one in. Hook attempt right there, going to miss. You miss 100% of the Tivo hooks you don't take. Wayne Gretzky said that. Or something like that. I'm going to warn and line those traps around the air. Level 2 traps, so 2 seconds now of lockdown. There's a Diva hook that lands. Bubbles gets pulled in, and he's just silenced as soon as he gets pulled in. That combo, man. Emerald Warden there to assist with the Diva hooks. It's brutal. Emerald Warden proving to be a very powerful pick here, and you kind of wonder with the hero like Dr. Pulsar really exploding onto the scene as a go-to hero in a lot of cases for really every team. Emerald Warden does seem like she could be a decent candidate to fight against it. Again, the 5 seconds, up to 5 seconds at level 4 of the silencing shot on the single target to lock down the Doctor. And I'm not saying this is the reason why they're just dominating this game by any means, but it's a good concept, and it makes sense, you know, in theory on paper and everything. And obviously, the execution here for Alliance is definitely working. So that's another reason why I'm really excited about this Dream Hack. I mean, I think you could also safely argue that going into this Dream Hack, we have the most diverse heroes as well that have been played going into it, let alone at the event itself, I'm sure. So, I mean, every single Dream Hack, it seems like we go in with, like, the obvious strategy in mind that we're probably going to be seeing from all the teams. Whether it's the trial lane, whether it's the jungle strat, or the 2-1-2, the 2-2-1, you know, the strength meta, whatever it is, the heal meta.
One,
this Dream Hack, we see jungler sometimes. We see trial lane sometimes. We see the 2-1-2. We see the 2-2-1s. You just don't know what to expect. I mean, we've seen so many heroes as of late on the competitive scene, and why wouldn't that continue going into Dream Hack? So, more reasons why this Dream Hack is just going to be extra amazing. Interesting. I'm sitting here. I mean, you look at his items. You see a Mighty Blade Warhammer. You're like, okay, so Shrunken Head going to be coming out here for Emerald Warden. Fousey's like, nope. Tricked you. He actually goes to Shieldbreak here, and I wonder if that has a lot to do with the fact that he just got a token. He's like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm just going to go with Shieldbreaker. Be more aggressive. I got a token of life anyways. Why not get more damage out? But, oh, nice dodge right there from Doct in the meantime. Able to avoid Devour. Not for a little much longer, though. He's actually gets cut off, though, and yeah, nice wall off, too, from Empath, and that'll prevent the chase. So, then in for a TP in. Not enough right there. Wretched Hag does have a full Grimoire, though. He's trying to chase, but Pat jumps inside Bubbles, and Bubbles will jet on out of there. Dr. Pulsar actually looking for a flank attempt, perhaps. No, he just wants to farm. Doctor just wants to farm, damn it. Pachoo! I love that. Pachoo! Poo-poo! Poo-poo! Get it again. fun stuff. Devour, he already has that barrier out of his own. The Tablet of Command on top of that. You see Tempest, Tat, Blood of Command, Shrunken Head. I haven't even mentioned those items until now, but yeah, they are farmed over here on the Hellborn side. Hanskin especially, man. 516 government. He continues to be the top in the game. He's been that way the whole game, actually. Oh, and apparently, Keeper of the Forest, hold on, thought he's going to be locked down right here. He does have the barrier idol. Going to use it up the last second. Can't slap to escape. Yes. He barely will. So just tanky enough to get away right there. But I just got word it looks like Stay Green. They do defeat Too Much Sugar 2-0 in their series. So Stay Green will face the loser of this series right now. Denali Esports look like they could be the one losing the series unless they get some amazing comeback in here in game number two. But Stay Green, they knock out Too Much Sugar. And of course, again, that means TMSR is going to be finishing in that fourth place spot here in Cycle 7. A solid finish. And again, I still think they're fairly happy in the end. They got some more decent practice going into the DreamHack event, and they will be there. And that's what a lot of these teams focuses on in the end, I'm sure. That's at least this last week or so. But so they finished fourth place. Stay Green going to be moving on to the loser bracket finals, where if these stand, I mean, no matter what, obviously it's going to be a great finish with the three teams that are left now. But Stay Green going to get a chance to get a rebuttal against Denali Esports, who again knocked them to the loser's bracket in that second round. And that'll be the first match tomorrow, of course.
The Hellborn have destroyed a Legion Tower.
Bottom lane easily destroyed by Lion. So now all outer towers have been destroyed in favor of Lion Esports Club here. Emerald Warden, see leveling up the Shieldbreaker, of course. Level 2 Shieldbreaker here. Bottom lane, Dr. Pulsar, he got locked down. Cannot do anything. Emerald Warden going to be ported with Nymphora. And here comes the bottom push now from Lions. And I don't see Denial stopping this. I mean, Keeper does have a root, but they're so out-leveled, so out-farmed here. It's going to take near perfect execution and several mistakes to happen from Lion Esports Club, so... They're going to try, though. Once again, nothing wrong with that. Kelp feels ready to go as well. They have to do something. I mean, you can't really just give up Rax here and expect to even still have a slight chance. Got to make your move at some point or another. You're just going to keep falling further and further behind. There we go, though. Devour's like, I'm going to make it happen. He hooks in Keeper. Keeper's bursted down before he can do a damn thing. He does buy back, though. Tevin's ultimate, however, to lock down Bubbles. Bubbles will fall. Dr. Pulse in the background. He blinks away. Not going to be enough. He falls. Empath being gone on now. That should do it. Lion Esports Club is going to take game number two, and that means they take the series 2-0. And they're going to be moving on to the grand finals yet again. So they're going to be looking for their third cycle victory. They've only dropped one game throughout these last two cycles here, and that was the previous round against Recent Gaming. They won that series 2-1, but they did drop a game against them. But in Cycle 6, they did not drop a game. They won the whole thing. Here in Cycle 7... They're on a crazy streak, man. These guys are looking really strong going into that DreamHack event, let alone the Grand Finals here of Haunt Tour Cycle number 7. So we'll see how they can keep it up in the Grand Finals tomorrow in the later match, but that means our Losers Bracket Finals is now set up. Stay Green versus Denial Esports is going to be the Loser Bracket Finals here on Honcast, of course, tomorrow for the earlier match. That, as always, is set to happen at 12 p.m. Eastern, 1800 Central European Time, and then the winner of that will play Lions in the Grand Finals. Of course, Lions will be up 1-0 as a result of coming from the winner's bracket. So, Cycle 7 shaping up yet again to be another great finish, but also yet again, Stay Green and Lions are a part of it. I'm actually thinking back off the top of my head here, but I think in the last, I think since Cycle 3 and on, I've basically been Stay Green and Lions Esports Club, so all about these two teams here in the Grand Finals, but they are there's good reason for that. Obviously, two very, very, very strong teams. So, Denali Esports, though, they will have a chance once again to prove that that wasn't a fluke there with the victory over Stay Green, that they can do it again. Will they be able to? We'll have to wait and see tomorrow. But that means our coverage today. We're going to be wrapping up here a fairly quicker day. I mean, our initial series got it, of course, was Too Much Sugar versus Team Excellent. That was a quicker match. Too Much Sugar winning that one 2-0. And then eventually came back into this one. Line